Hello everybody, our subject name is Machine Learning and Application, myself Professor Pinkal Shukla, IT Department. So in the last video, we focused the techniques for dimensionality reduction. So we saw the two techniques, and next two techniques we will see in the further video. Okay. So the third technique is manifold learning, and the fourth one is the autoencoder method. So let's see one by one. So first one is the manifold learning. So this is the technique from high dimensionality statics can also be used for dimensionality reduction. So by using the high dimensionality statics, this reduction is actually used. So this technique is also called as a manifold learning. Okay. So it is used to create a low dimensional projection of high dimensional data, often for the purpose of a data visualization. These techniques are generally used for the data visualization. So the projection is defined to both create low dimensional representation of the data set while best preserving the salient structure and relationship in the data. So this learning is actually used to design low dimensional representation of the data and also preserve some of the different types of structure and relationship of the data. So consider one example. So rank ordering of Euclidean and distance not preserved in a manifold learning. So here distance of A to C is Euclidean and distance of A to B is given. So this figure suggests that distance of A to B is larger than that of distance of A to C. And here consider the example distance of A to C and distance of A to B. So distance of A to C is larger than that of distance of A to B. So rank ordering of that Euclidean distance is not preserved in the manifold distance. You cannot say that the ordering is here. Okay, so it is a non-metric MDS or manifold. So what are actually the manifold? Manifold is a mathematical space that on a small enough scale resembles on that space of a specific dimension. Euclidean space have to dimension or resemble their inner space. Okay, hence the line of circle are one-dimensional manifolds in a plane or a sphere of two-dimensional manifold. There is a one line or two-dimensional manifolds out there. So consider there is a S shape and this is the Swiss roll. Okay, so both are the two-dimensional data embedded in the 3D. Two-dimensional data, both are embedded in 3D. So manifold learning is the we have to make the data relationship and structure relationship with that also reducing that dimensionality. Consider that image, N of M is given, but here we actually reduce the dimensionality. Also, we focus on some of the data and structure attributes. And the next one is the autoencoder method. Okay. So, deep learning neural network can be constructed to perform the dimensionality reduction. So neural network is to be constructed, some of the neural network which is based on some deep learning technologies are actually used to reduce that dimensionality reduction. So this popular approach is also known as an autoencoder. Okay, so this involves the self-supervised learning problem where a model must reproduce the input correctly. So this is already trained model which is self-supervised learning model, where model is already trained to reproduce the data or input correctly. So deep learning neural network can be constructed to perform the dimensionality prediction. So this is the autoencoder, automatically encode the correct input data. So a popular approach is called as an autoencoder. Okay, so this involves the framing a self-supervised learning problem where a model must reproduce the input correctly. So this is two small techniques, which is manifold learning and autoencoder method. Okay, so this is all about the learning method. I hope you understood the before video and this video totally, and you understood four different types of techniques. If any problem, mention into the comment section. Okay, thank you.